Hey, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at a LEGO Star Wars set. This is the 2014 version of the Jedi Interceptor. This particular set comes with 223 pieces. They've done this design of ship before multiple times. I think the first time it was actually billed as a Jedi Starfighter. And the designs on all of them, the builds are very remarkably similar. You know, they haven't changed a whole lot. They haven't completely redesigned the whole thing, because it's still, I think they just got it, they did a good enough job to begin with that it hasn't needed to be really redesigned. The major thing that's changed for this one, the big new feature, is that they've included the spring-loaded launchers this time, and you've got two of those, so you can see your little laser bolts here. It makes it a little bit difficult to hold the thing, because normally you'd probably want to hold it like under here. And if you do that, your fingers are going to be blocking the bolts, so maybe you kind of go from top and bottom or something like that. But these things, if you haven't seen them by now, they're pushed down a little bit and they shoot these little transparent bolts out. And they're very easy to set off, so it's not something that you want to ever face at somebody's face, because eyes will be taken out. They're kind of a little bit dangerous, but they do shoot very well. What else we've got going on here? Of course, the wing tips can still fold, so for the sake of landing, you would want to just fold the bottom ones up. You know, it makes it convenient to actually set the thing down on the ground. And we've got a smaller logo used here this time. The canopy opens up, actually opens from here, and there you can see Anakin in there with space for his lightsaber hilt and his lightsaber blade. Ha! Separate those out. Hey, for the sake of play, it's good to be able to have a spot for those rather than just, you know, trying to throw them into the cockpit and hope that they don't get lost. And then you can see the nice sticker that they use for the console bit there. Not too bad looking. I kind of would have preferred a slightly rounded slope piece right there. Would have, you know, give it a little bit of depth, but that's okay. It's not too bad. And then the canopy holds itself in place with one single stud in the middle and a jumper piece. And R2-D2 is going to fit in here sideways. You just turn his head to the side. See, it's not, you know, it's the orientation. Shoulders are front to back, but, you know, does the trick and gets the look. So, you know, like I said, it's something they've done before, so nothing too new here, but it looks good. For figures here, we get a new version of Anakin, this time with that strange gold headband headset thing that kind of reminds me of the piece from Wonder Woman. And then we get a new version of R2-D2, as if there weren't enough of those out there already. This one has the more demure silver and dark blue. Lots of dark blue on this one, so it's just making it look a little bit, I don't know, that might actually be closer to correct this version. You know, it's a little bit, possibly a little bit more realistic. I don't know. I think that's something that's up for debate. Feel free to share your thoughts, whether you like the new R2-D2 or you like some of the older versions better. I'm a little bit torn. I wish that they had printing on the back of the main droid torso here, but I do like the top. I like the top piece. That to me is an improvement. For Anakin, he actually does have two faces here, even though he does have the headset on. So back here, you can see the alternate version. There you can see the full headset, you know, the forehead connection point a little bit better. And he's got some age lines in his face. And there you can see just a better look at the print from the front and some of the small little bits of print on there. Yep, this is just another very small evolution on a design that was already good to begin with. So it's basically, you know, they're just adding little bits of changes to something that is already successful, and it's better than just leaving the exact same thing on the shelves all the time. This is a hero main fighter, so it sells. It is something that kids want, so that's why they keep bringing it back. It's a big deal. It's something that kids want to be able to grab and take the helm of. You know, you want to be the main good guy in the main good guy craft, and this is an opportunity to do that. So, well done, LEGO. Folks who already have one of the older versions can continue to be happy with and proud of their older versions. But if the older ones were good, well, this one's just a little bit better. That's my opinion. Feel free to share your opinion in the comments section, and I'll be talking to you again very soon because I've always got new videos on the way. And you can follow all my updates at JANGBRiCKS.com. Bye for now.